would like to do today is to show you some details about mini PCNL. We don't do any live surgery today, but we would like to show you some details of mini PCNL, which make it easier, make it more safe, and probably there are some details which may reduce the complication rate. And we usually perform our mini PCNL in a prone position. And what I first want to do is to introduce you to the positioning. We are using a fixed X-ray table. You can see this here. This is a fixed X-ray table. This is the X-ray coming from above, and patient is put into prone position. Of course, we don't have a patient today, but we can ask Ute to lie down over there, please. And what you can see clearly is this special cushion. This is the inflatable cushion, which allows us to adjust the particular position of the body for mini PCNL. Please, Ute, you can lie down. Okay. We just remove the clothes a little, like this. Etwas nach oben gehen. Okay. What we usually do is that we put the cushion under this coverage in order to keep it clean. In order to make it more easier to learn how the cushion is working. Andere Kamera vielleicht mal. This is the cushion now, and we are using air pressure. We are connecting it. And this is easy to adjust now. Mal zeigen bitte das Bild. Andere Kamera. Andere Kamera. Nein, die andere Kamera. Ah ja, okay, muss man vielleicht so zeigen. Okay, so ist gut. Okay. Das Bild ist ganz grisselig. Woran liegt's? Okay. Now we can adjust the cushion to the particular shape of body. For example, like this. Or we can deflate the cushion. And we can also do this during the operation. Just once more.
So this is your bolster.
This is very comfortable.
Yeah. This is your central bolster.
Okay. Yes. This is in order to facilitate the puncture, because in some patients, it is very difficult to get a good access to the lower pole. And you can also change the positioning during the surgery. This is also an advantage. For example, you're opening this, and the patient is coming down. And sometimes under ultrasound control, the puncture is facilitated by deflating this cushion. Okay? Okay, dann mal das Ultraschallgerät angeben. Gleiche Kamera. Herr Anudo. Ultraschall.
Then are you able to listen to
us? Next thing we... Yes, the next step is now to show you, etwas aus dem Bild gehen, Herr Anudo, ich sehe sonst nichts, okay. We are showing you our particular ultrasound probe. From my point of view, this is really a very, very suitable ultrasound probe. Nochmal das Detail zeigen. Detail zeigen. Okay, this is a special ultrasound probe. Moment, ja. Okay, so ist gut. Ist gut so. And if you have a close look, you can see that the surface of the probe is interrupted. And if we have a puncture needle, we can insert the puncture needle here. And the puncture needle passes the ultrasound probe in the middle, over there. das Detail bitte mal zeigen?
Yeah, we can see that.
Okay, we are showing the detail. So far as I know, this is the only ultrasound probe which allows to insert the needle through the probe. You can see this, okay?
Yes, yes.
And after the puncture is successful, you can remove it easily, like this. Okay, etwas Gel. Gel, Herr Anuro. Now we are showing the ultrasound image. Kann man das Ultraschallbild mal zeigen? Freeze-Taste. Dann die R-Taste. Reverse. Nee, das ist Mitte rechts. Mitte rechts auf dem Touchscreen. Auf den, ja, rechts, 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 unten. Yes. Okay, dann die B-Taste ein bisschen hochdrehen. Haben wir Ultraschallbild drauf? Ja. We are showing the ultrasound probe. Ja. Bild drauf geben. Auf Sendebild? Nee, wir müssen das noch hier drauf kriegen, ne? Jetzt die Biopsie reintun. Oben links drücken. Biopsie Puncture Line. Oben links, ganz oben links, ganz oben links, ja, okay. And now this is very easy to hit the calicial system through the lower calyx. Of course, Ute does not suffer from any nephrolithiasis, therefore I cannot show you any calculus. Okay. Dr. Pahl already told us that it is very important, Übersicht bitte, that it is very important to insert a urethral catheter prior to the PCNL. We are using a special balloon catheter. This is the balloon catheter. This is inverted prior to surgery. Bitte mal das Detail zeigen. Okay, das Detail dann zeigen. Ja. Noch weiter rechts. Gut. Weiter rechts. Mehr Detail. Gut. Okay.
Yes, yes, we can see
now,
that.
Now you can see.
Yeah.
This is the tip of the urethral catheter.
Yes.
It is very flat. And this is not as a normal guide wire. It is 10 millimeters longer over there. This is 10 millimeters longer. This facilitates the insertion of the balloon catheter. Flexible tip, like this. Mehr Übersicht. And this is a special adapter. You can remove the guide wire inside, like this. This balloon catheter also fits for normal PTFE coated guide wires. And there are two connections. One is to apply contrast dye, and one is to inflate the balloon. And I can do this now by injection of air. Detail nochmal zeigen. Now you can see that the balloon catheter is inflated. Just a moment. Yeah. It's not so good with air, but it works. Just a moment. So, this is the balloon.
Yeah, we can see that.
Okay, this is also very suitable because you can apply a mixture of contrast dye, methylene blue, and methylene blue. And this is really another help to be very sure that you hit the calicial system at the correct place, okay? Okay, now we can show you the instruments we are using. Okay, mal aufstehen, den Ultraschall abnehmen. gerade mal rumkommen, Ute, auf diese Seite. This is the whole table we need for mini PCNL. And what you can clearly see is that there is nothing needed. Only 3 or 4 items, nothing more. This is the puncture needle. Bisschen mehr aufzoomen. Puncture needle.
Yes.
This is a guide wire. This is a normal stainless steel guide wire. Very cheap.
Yes.
No problem.
Okay.
The second item. This is the single step dilator. Only one dilator. Very durable. You can use it for 5 years, 10 years, 15 years. And the stainless steel ampler sheath and the nephroscope. Now, if you do the puncture, you first use the puncture needle. Then you invert the guide wire. The puncture needle is taken out. Okay. And the single step dilator is put on the guide wire. This is really a very cheap guide wire. Nothing else is needed. This is the single step dilator under fluoroscopic control, of course. Then you remove the guide wire and you take this special amplatz sheath. And this amplatz sheath fits exactly to the dilator. You put it on the single dilator, push it forward, and remove the dilator. And after that, you can invert the nephroscope through the amplatz sheath. That's all. And you all know that it is very important to have a certain space between the tip of the nephroscope. Detail bitte mal. So nah, wie es geht, hier auf die Spitze vom Moment. There is a certain space between the nephroscope and the amplatz sheath. And this is the space where all the small fragments are migrating out of the calicial system. Okay, which means we don't need any forceps, any graspers. This is always a low pressure condition in the calicial system because the amplatz sheath is not closed here. We don't have any closure of the amplatz sheath. And this means that there is only a very low, almost zero pressure of the calicial system. And after we have finished the procedure, we are inserting the guide wire once more through the amplatz sheath. And finally, a nephrostomy tube is inserted. This is a 12 French balloon nephrostomy tube. Very comfortable, no problem. Of course, you can also perform tubeless PCNL. It depends on your preference. Nochmal etwas die Übersicht vom Tisch zeigen. Den Tisch nochmal zeigen. What you can clearly see is that the equipment from original mini PCNL is almost nothing. You really only need these three things. That's all. Everything is available in the operating theater. This makes it very easy. If I travel to India, for example, I only take these three things. That's all. Okay. I'm not sure if there are any questions. According to our demonstration, Dr. Pal.
Thank you, Swin. Am I audible to all? Anybody?
We.
Yeah.
Okay.
Hello.
If there are no questions, we go on with the short presentation.
Sorry, you want.
Übersicht.
You are giving some concluding remarks, Dr. Swin. Swin, am I audible to you? Dr. Pal here.
Yes, I'm hearing you very well.
Okay. Now you want to give some concluding remarks?
Yes, just a moment. We switch to PowerPoint. Just a moment. Gerade mal die PowerPoint-Präsentation aufrufen.
Yes, sir, we
ich
can
sehe es see ja your... schon. Okay, weiter. Es wird gesendet. Okay, you can see this, ne? Yes, I think the main thing in order to reduce the complication rate is to minimize the tract size. There is a lot of literature telling us that the risk factor for blood loss after PNL is the tract size. Next one. And this is the original paper, which is almost now 20 years old. And it's interesting to see that there are some regions worldwide who do not perform mini PCNL up to now. Okay, next slide, please. This is a comparison of mini PCNL to conventional PCNL. And if you have a look at the next slide, you can clearly see, weiter, that there is almost 20% of the cross-section left if you are using a mini PCNL instrument. Next. This is a French nephroscope. The AMTAT cheese have an inner diameter of 15 French. And the working channel is 6 French, which is really very, very large. And the viewing angle is 12 French. Next one. And this is now a short overview of the steps of the surgical procedure. This is a large lower calcical stone. Next. And the retrograde pyelography, you can clearly see the balloon ureteral catheter, which leads to a certain dilation of the renal calcical system. Next one. After that, the patient is put into prone position. The puncture of the lower calyx is done under ultrasound guidance. Next one. And the mini PCNL AMTAT shaft is inserted. We are only using laser lithotripsy. Next. All small fragments are coming out of the calcical system without any forceps, automatically only by means of irrigation flow. This is the stone-free status. And we are finishing the procedure with the insertion of the nephrostomy tube. Next one. This is our laser. This is a conventional holmium laser with 70 watts and 60 hertz. But to be honest, you don't need such a big laser. 20 to 30 watts is really enough. 20 hertz is enough. You are equal effective if you are using a smaller laser. Next one. The main type of stone disintegration is stone dusting, which means low energy and high frequency. The aim is to have very small fragments. Next one. And this table shows you that there is really a good success of the mini PCNL technique. And so far, with this combined ultrasound and fluoroscopic guided puncture, we don't had any severe complications, only very minor complications like pyelonephritis or small alterations. Next one. And if we compare the mini PCNL to conventional PCNL, there are some main differences. It is not only the size of the nephroscope, it is also the kind of lithotripsy. And the main difference is the kind of stone removal. In mini PCNL, the stone fragments are coming automatically out of the calcical system. If you perform conventional PCNL, you need forceps and baskets. And therefore, this special minimally invasive kind of PCNL leads to a significant reduction of transfusion rate. Next. This leads to my conclusions and my last slide. Miniaturized PCNL is used more and more. It is decreasing morbidity, and we do have comparable stone-free rates. And we don't have no significant longer operative time because the stone fragments are washed out by irrigation flow, and we don't need time to use forceps or baskets. But it is very important to know that the success is depending on the experience and the knowledge of numerous surgical details. And some of these details, this was our aim, were shown today. And finally, we can say that mini PCNL is the treatment of choice in upper urinary tract stones exceeding 1 or 2 centimeters in diameter. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much, Swain, and you have to, thanks to your team, all team members, you have taken extra efforts. You are there with us all this time, and you have demonstrated, you have shown us your theater and your technique. And I feel your attribute, your success and minimal complications to one thing, you are occluding the PUJ. So everything has to come out only through one track, and therefore all the stone fragments will come out. You are using ultrasound technology to puncture, and you are using irrigation to remove all the stones very easily. Your particular this abdominal bolster probably stabilizes the kidney, as you have been telling us, and puncture becomes much easier. So all these technical modifications have made your technique.
What we can
show you is you have made it very
How we are managing the irrigation. Zeigen Sie mal mit der Kamera bitte auf die Irrigation, oben den Deckenlifter.
We
can show you how we are doing the irrigation. Just a moment. Was denn?
We are getting very interesting questions, but we are running short of time.
Auf den.
So we will ask, there are so many questions to swing.
Only just 10 seconds?
Yeah. Dr. Shivaji Basu, Dr. Panigrahi, they are there with us. Dr. Kaushik Shah has also joined in.
Deckenlifter. Okay, what you can see is this. This is where the water is put. Okay. And this is the automatic lift to the ceiling. This is very, very inexpensive, very cheap. Okay. And the height is enough to have a good irrigation flow. Okay.
Thank you, Swain. You can stop sharing, and we have really learned a lot from your demonstration and from your talk. And mainly economy is a very important thing for India, which you have shown all the cheaper technologies. So can you stop sharing your screen? Thank you very much to you and to your team.
Yes, thank you very much for inviting us, and a very well organized webinar. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much, sir, Steve, sir. He has taken a lot of pain to show to the theater on Saturday. Saturday he has taken time, permission, and then went into the theater, used his assistance for lying down on the table. Is great, really great. Highly appreciate.
He has made it so simple, only 3 instruments and minimum intervention. And he says that the things will be so easy.